Hi everyone, Dr. Kalaiko here, and today I want to talk about blood clots and the COVID-19 vaccines. So you may have been following the news that in the US, the CDC and the FDA have recommended a pause in the distribution of the Johnson & Johnson or Janssen vaccine in response to 6 cases of a rare but very serious blood clotting disorder. And similarly, in Europe and other countries that have been distributing the AstraZeneca vaccine, there have been reports also of this rare blood clotting condition. So what do we know so far? So what we know, these two vaccines have in common is they have a similar mechanism of action or the way that they work in the body. So both of these vaccines are adenovirus vaccines. That means that they contain the instructions on how to make the spike protein. So that's that protein that goes on the outside of the coronavirus. Now, these vaccines that are adenoviruses, they use DNA instead of mRNA, which is, if you'll recall, the Pfizer and the Moderna vaccines use mRNA. Now, these vaccines that use DNA have the advantage of being able to be refrigerated for a longer period of time as opposed to frozen or kept at ultra cold temperatures, because they tend to be more stable at those higher temperatures compared with the mRNA vaccines. Now, what we see in the European Union and what we've observed is that there have been 86 cases of this rare but serious type of blood clot called cerebral venous sinus thrombosis, or CVST, combined with thrombocytopenia or low platelets. And most of these cases have occurred in women under the age of 60, and it happened within 2 weeks of receiving the AstraZeneca vaccine. Now, it is important to remember that this adverse event is extremely rare. So 25 million people in Europe have already received the AstraZeneca vaccine compared with those 86 cases. However, they are, you know, it is, as I mentioned, very serious. Some of these folks who had this event actually died from it. And so this is under ongoing investigation by the EMA, which is the regulatory agency in Europe. So like the counterpart of our US FDA. And in the meantime, several countries have issued age-based restrictions on the AstraZeneca vaccine, limiting it to older adults. So some countries are allowing it in patients over the age of 30, others are recommending over the age of 50, etc. Now, in the U.S., with the Johnson & Johnson or Janssen vaccine, we have seen 6 cases of CVST with thrombocytopenia, and all of those cases have occurred in white women under the age of 50, and those have occurred within 3 weeks of receiving the vaccine. Now, again, for context, nearly 7 million doses of the Janssen vaccine have been given in the U.S. So, again, extremely rare, approximately 1 in a million is what we're talking about here. So just to give you a little bit of context, you know, the risk of general blood clots from having severe COVID, so being hospitalized with COVID, for example, is much, much higher compared with your risk of blood clots from getting the vaccine. Same with blood clot risk from smoking, from taking certain types of hormonal birth control, and from being pregnant. Those risks, the risk of blood clots with any of those conditions is much higher compared with what we're talking about here with the vaccine. It is important to remember that CVST with thrombocytopenia is a different type of blood clot from the type that we see associated with smoking, birth control, etc. And the risk of this type of blood clot is much, much lower. So meaning it's more rare. And also for the healthcare professionals out there, CVST with thrombocytopenia is treated very differently from most of your typical blood clots. For example, you would not use heparin to treat CVST with thrombocytopenia because that could actually make it worse. So in these cases, you know, the patient needs to see a hematologist and get that specialist care. So the hypothesis of why this is occurring is that in some people, their immune response to the vaccine may trigger the production of antibodies that cause blood clots and reduce platelets. So it looks very similar to heparin-induced thrombocytopenia. So all this to say this is really a sign that our adverse event monitoring program is working as intended. And so some of you may know that there is this system called VAERS in which healthcare professionals report serious adverse events for, you know, anybody that has, you know, side effects after vaccination. And so the fact that they were able to pick up these six cases very quickly, you know, within a short amount of time and respond to it is showing that this system is working as intended. So their recommendation to pause the distribution of the vaccine while the CDC conducts its investigation was made out of an abundance of caution. Now, if you have already received the J&J vaccine or the Janssen vaccine within the last 3 weeks, know the warning signs of CVST. So things like having a severe headache, abdominal pain, leg pain, shortness of breath, for example. If you experience symptoms like these, contact your healthcare provider right away and seek advice. And this is different from the general common and expected side effects from any of the COVID vaccines, which would include mild to moderate headaches, fatigue, muscle and joint pain, nausea. All of those are common and expected. But if you feel like something's not right in your body and you feel concerned, please don't hesitate to contact your healthcare provider and ask them. So I want to end with a reminder that we have seen over 31.4 million cases of COVID-19 in the US and 564,000 deaths from COVID. So we are still in the midst of a very serious and deadly pandemic. And the only way that we can have hope of ending this situation is by getting everybody vaccinated. So know that this type of blood clot is not associated with the Pfizer or the Moderna vaccines, for example. So in the meantime, while we await more information from the CDC, both of these mRNA vaccines are still available in the US, and they are both extremely safe and extremely effective at preventing hospitalizations and deaths from COVID-19. So I hope that helps, and I'll see you next time.